When I listen to Raymond Scott's music, I really can see the 20th century's DNA kind of unpacked.
A prophet is not without honor except in his own country.
He was before his time in his music and his thinking. He was always experimenting, always.
He was totally unique. I don't hear in his music it coming from anywhere.
He was not only the Frank Zappa of his time, he was also an audio version of Andy Warhol.
The top seven songs of the week with Raymond Scott and the Hit Parade Orchestra.
That's my father. In the 1950s, when I was about 10, he was the orchestra leader on that show, Your Hit Parade. He had become really famous in the 1930s with a group called the Raymond Scott Quintette.
The quintet was extremely popular. They debuted in late 1936 on CBS radio, and the audience reaction was stunning. Within 6 months, they were out in Hollywood, appearing in films, making lots of recordings.
In the 1940s, Warner Brothers began licensing his music for use in their cartoons.
I used to tape Roadrunner cartoons from the TV because they didn't have very much dialogue on them, and you would hear like...
The drummer makes tick-tock sounds, and then a whole new tempo and feel starts. This, the middle section of Powerhouse, could have been a piece on its own.
Scott and others created music that was not Russian, was not Jewish, it was quintessentially American.
He was different, very different, and he sort of became a boyfriend. And then we didn't have a wedding, we just eloped. And he didn't want children, but we had children. But he never spent that much time with them.
If he was around, he wasn't really engaged with us. He was doing his music thing.
He goes over to the electronium, and he starts playing with this thing, and this flood of sound comes out. And I'm thinking, holy cow, this is nothing like what anybody else is doing.
There was a period where he had developed the most sophisticated equipment in the world.
It's very rare that you have someone who is both a composer and technically skilled enough to make the machinery. Can you imagine Mozart making a violin?
He refers to the electronium. He said, it's really a cockpit of dreams. And this is it. If you have this in your house, you're like Jean-Luc Picard on the Starship Enterprise. I would never go out.
I guess it's the creative process which is most enjoyable. I could go on just experimenting and inventing and trying things for the rest of my life. Just for the pure joy of making up things.